Good afternoon, Honorable Vice-Chancellor Professor Podile Appa Rao garu, Dean S.N.School Professor P.Thirumal, the speaker of this distinguished lecture, Jayant Prakash Kastuar garu, and welcome to all my colleagues, guests and students. I request Vice-Chancellor Appa Rao garu to please come onto the dais and light the lamp. As a Professor P.Thirumal, Shri.Jayant garu, thank you, sir. Nataraja Ramakrishna garu memorial lecture is being conducted as part of the distinguished lecture series of the University of Hyderabad this year. We begin the proceedings of this afternoon by a film made by one of the students of S.N.School as a tribute to this great legend, Padma Shri Natyacharya Nataraja Ramakrishna garu.
Nataraja Ramakrishna anna vyakti prapanchamulo putti lokaniki kala seva chesadu ani cheppi lokam telusukovali gaani nenu 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 annadi ee nenu anna shabdam nenu chaala kaalam marchipoyanu.
A legendary dancer, a revered guru, a zealous scholar, founding father of the Department of Dance in the University of Hyderabad, Dr. Nataraja Ramakrishna is a man of many endearing qualities. An exponent of many dance forms, he had also resurrected ancient art forms like Perani Sivatandavam and a 2000-year-old dance tradition called Andhra Natyam. He had dedicated his entire life selflessly to bring these art forms onto the fore. He had mastered the technique of Satvika Abhinayam and believed that it carries the ultimate essence of dance.
Andamaina neemu andamaina neemu nenu appila unde kalatare kalatare maatladali hastal gadu hastal anta ipoyi cheeks cheeks la color raavali aa rangu raavali aa tejas raavali kannalalo aa kaanti prakashinchadu adi ఆంధ్రలో కృషి అలా చేసినప్పుడు ఆలయంలో కృష్ణుడు అలా వచ్చేయాలి రమ్మంటే రావాలి రామయ్య పెళ్ళి అని చెప్పాడు చాలా ప్రసిద్ధి చెందాడు ఆయన ఇలా ఉండాడు పెద్ద తలకాయ రావణాసురుడు పెద్ద బొట్టు ఇటు పెట్టుకుని అందరూ భయపడేవారు ఆయన నా కదా వీడేంటే నిర్లక్ష్యం ఎందుకంటే అభినేత నా చేతిలో ఉంది ఆయన చూసి ఇదికి హస్తంగా లేవు అంటే ముద్ర లేవు అన్నాడు నేను అన్నాను మీ ముద్రాభయం ఎక్కడ ఎండ్ అవుతుంది మీ ముద్ర అభినయం ఎక్కడ ఎండ్ అవుతుందో అక్కడ మా సాత్విక అభినయం స్టార్ట్ అవుతుంది.
He was famous for his on-stage spontaneity and enthralled the audiences wherever he performed.
ఇది కుర్తాలం స్వామీజీ నేను వైజాగ్ వడ్డకి ఒకసారి వచ్చారు తెలుగు స్వామిజీ ఆయన వడ్డాది బాపరాజు గారి నాడ మీద ఉన్నాం రామకృష్ణ గారు మిమ్మల్ని చూడడానికి వచ్చారు మీ అభినయం చూడండి ఆయన ఒక కుర్చీ వేసి ఆయన శిష్యులంతా వచ్చి ఆ స్వామీజీకి ధన్యవాదం పులి చర్మం అంతా వేసి కూర్చున్నారు సార్ ఏదో చెప్పి చేయి నాయనా అన్నారు. అప్పుడు ఏం చేయాలి? ఏదో కాదు, ఈ స్వామీజీ నాకు కొంచెం ఆడుకోవాలి. స్వామీజీ హృదయంతో బుద్ధి పుట్టి అభినయం అంటే ఏం కాదు, చేసేవాడు చూసేవాడు యొక్క హృదయంతో ఆడుకోవాలి, అది అభినయం అంటే.
హీ హ్యాడ్ ఆల్సో స్పియర్హెడెడ్ ద రెనోవేషన్ ఆఫ్ ద టూమ్స్ ఆఫ్ తారామతి అండ్ బారాదరి.
ఒకప్పుడు రాజులు మహారాజులు కళాకారులు అందరూ కూడా వచ్చి ఇక్కడ ఆ నృత్య వినోదాలని సంగీతాన్ని ఆస్వాదించేవారు. ఈనాడు ఏమీ లేదే అని చెప్పి నేను ఆవేదన కలిగింది. దాని గురించి నేను 5 సంవత్సరాలు కృషి చేశాను, ప్రభుత్వాన్ని కోరాను, ప్రభుత్వం వారు అంగీకరించారు.
ఇట్ ఈస్ అ ప్రివిలేజ్ దట్ హి హస్ చోజన్ టు గివ్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ రేర్ అవార్డ్స్ కన్ఫర్డ్ టు హిమ్ టు అవర్ యూనివర్సిటీ టు బి కెప్ట్ అండ్ డిస్ప్లేడ్ ఇన్ ఇట్స్ పోర్టల్స్. Words fall short in describing his contribution to University of Hyderabad. He had trained many dancers, guided many scholars, authored many books, and above all, inspired all of us. Dr. Nataraja Ramakrishna, an epitome of knowledge, dedication, and humility.
Chadiviti sakala shastramulu andali saramulella grahinchiti anta vijnana netrambu vippichuda telisukuntini nakemi teliyadunchu.
Thank you, Professor Aruna. Distinguished guest, Sri.Jayant Kastuar, respected Vice-Chancellor, Professor Appa Rao Podile, Professor Aruna Bhikshu, the head of the department, Professor Anuradha Garu, Professor Shivaraju, colleagues, students, friends, I am delighted to welcome you to this year's edition of Nataraja Ramakrishna Memorial Lecture. When I joined the university in 1998, Professor Nataraja Ramakrishna was very active. I think he just retired at that time. It looks as if some people live their entire life for the sake of society. And Professor Nataraja Ramakrishna lived his life, as you saw in the documentary, for the sake of art and art education. I see him not merely as the founder of the dance department, but as laying the ground for S.N.School of Arts and Communication. The school has grown in an enviable manner, and thanks to such remarkable personalities who were at the moment of initiation, they were the guiding personalities. I would like here to mention some of the distinguished personalities who have given the memorial lecture, namely Kapila Vatsayan, Leela Samson, Anuradha Kapoor, and so on. I'm pleased to invite a distinguished guest, Jayant Kastuar, former secretary of the Sangeet Natak Akademi, India's National Academy of Music, Dance and Drama, Jayant Prakash Kastuar is an eminent Kathak dance exponent. This is, I read out from the Google. I'm sure there is a larger introduction to the speaker from Professor Aruna. Art administrator, expert, curator, scholar, and designer in the world of Indian performing arts. So he's here to deliver this year's Sri Nataraja Ramakrishna Memorial Lecture. Sir, thank you for accepting our invitation and honoring us with your presence. I thank our Vice-Chancellor, Professor Appa Rao Podile, for being extremely sensitive to the very different needs of the school. It's not the same needs as humanities, social science, or sciences. and he's been a scientist, but has been very encouraging. Thanks for being here, sir. I welcome one and all who have gathered here this evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Thirumal. Indeed, it's my honor to introduce the distinguished speaker of Nataraja Ramakrishna Memorial Lecture, Jayant Prakash Kastuar. Jayant Prakash Kastuar is a widely known name in the fraternity of Indian dance. He had a great contribution to almost all the Indian dance forms as an administrator, art curator, and an artist himself. Mr. Kastuar started the journey of dance as a disciple of legendary Kathak Pandit, Kathak under the tutelage of the legendary Pandit Durgalal, and has emerged as a complete personality of an artist, art administrator, and cultural activist. He was born in 1956 in Jamshedpur and educated at St. Stephen's College, University of Delhi. Jayant Kastuar represents a rare combination of excellence in classical dance, academics, and public service. His series of work for the dance traditions of India, Kathakali, Kuchipudi, Odissi, Manipuri, Kathak, Satriya, and Chau, have been widely known and acclaimed nationally and in the respective regions. He toured in the interiors of these regions and designed and organized many seminars and lectures. Equally significant were his initiatives in the field of Indian music. He played a key role in establishing the special category of major music traditions in the scheme of Academy Awards. Similarly, Kastuar made a significant contribution to the traditions as well as contemporary practices of Indian theatre through plans that provided wholesome training in contemporary theatre countrywide. He simultaneously guided Academy's work of publication, documentation, and dissemination and reached out to artists, teachers, scholars, and institutions of performing arts all over the nation. In fact, he had joined Sangeet Natak Akademi as the head of the Faculty of Dance and then had taken up as the secretary of Sangeet Natak Akademi for a long tenure. If I'm right, he was the only one who was in that position for almost 12 and a half years as secretary of Sangeet Natak Akademi. And he was also looking into heading also Bharat Kala Kendra, which is presently called Kathak Kendra. His appropriation with this afternoon's lecture is quite obvious to all of us because of his association with Dr. Nataraj Ramakrishna from 1988. He was associated with him as an administrator on behalf of Sangeet Natak Akademi and supported all his seminars on Kalamantula Natyam, the dance tradition, the Devadasi dance tradition of Andhra region. And also he was the catalyst in bringing out seminars and festivals of Kuchipudi and elite dance forms, which had taken place between 1993 and 1997. And also I would like to recollect his association with the Department of Dance through a teacher's training in workshop in Yakshagana, where he invited a legendary master, Pasumarthi Venugopalakrishna Sarmagaru. It was a 40-day long workshop for young dance teachers in 2000. That was in collaboration with Sarojini Naidu School of Arts and Communication. Mr. Kastuar has been a great support in organizing seminars on Kolamantulo, as I said earlier. This association of him with Guru Nataraja Ramakrishna was very great, and they had a great bonding, and he observed Guruji's contribution towards research of dance and also reconstruction of many Telugu dance traditions. We are happy to see you today, sir, in the premises of the university, because it is a bit nostalgic to most of us who are associated with these festivals and also Guruji. I welcome you once again, and his lecture this evening is about practice and policies of performing arts in India, a national perspective. When he confirmed the topic to us, he said his view or his take of a national perspective is entirely different. It's not something which is based in Delhi or Delhi Center. We are looking forward for your lecture, sir. Welcome you once again. Before Jayanji starts his lecture, I request Vice-Chancellor Professor Appa Rao Garu to felicitate him on behalf of the University of Hyderabad. I request Professor Appa Rao Garu to kindly address the gathering and also a guest.
Our distinguished speaker for this year's Nataraja Ramakrishna Memorial Lecture, Jayantji, my colleagues from S.N.School, invited guests, students from university. This is always a very, very special occasion for a university like this to remember great personalities who have been pillars of the Sarojini Naidu School of Performing Arts. And his name itself speaks several things for those who know the name. Such a legend personality we are remembering and we are trying to honor by also inviting somebody who is closely associated with him. In the last few minutes I realized that Jayantji has closely worked with Nataraja Ramakrishna Garu. And therefore, it's even more honor to have a speaker like him to deliver this lecture today. I extend a warm welcome to the speaker, Jayantji, on behalf of university and on my personal behalf. And thank you very much for taking your time for this particular occasion. Our S.N.School, Professor P.Thirumal has mentioned, has a rich tradition, and probably we are a unique school in the country. There may be schools, each school may have some one specialization where they are very well known, but I have a feeling, not just because I am Vice Chancellor here, but because I have been a faculty at this university for most 30 years, I have seen that this school has recognition in multiple art forms. So therefore, it is a great pleasure to be part of the activities of the school, and sometimes I envy the students of the school that they got such a wonderful opportunity, and maybe some of us at every age may not have got such kind of an opportunity to learn the different art forms in this from top figures, be it in the fine arts, be it in dance, be it in theater, or even in communication, which has become part of this performing arts school. That way, and the tradition that the university has maintained to commemorate the great personalities who have been associated with the university, otherwise made contributions to the form of education, is something which always goes in the history of the university as a great contribution. and it gives an immense opportunity. Such a great personality, and the last sentence that we saw in the documentary, in the last statement, after everything, he says that I don't know anything now. So such is the humility of the great people, and it is for the students to learn from such kind of people, such contributors, and how still we should be respecting the form, and we respect the people around us. And with this, I would not like to stand before you and the speaker, and I would like to congratulate the school for the initiative, and thank once again our speaker for taking his time and joining us today to deliver this year's Nataraj Ramakrishna Garu Memorial Lecture. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vice Chancellor.
Namaskar. I'm extremely thankful to the university, the Honorable Vice Chancellor, the Dean, and Dr. Aruna, the present head, for making it possible for me to come back to the university again. And this time, of course, to pay my homage in words once again to Dr. Nataraj Ramakrishna ji, Guruji, whom I consider as one of my gurus in Abhinaya. In fact, whenever I perform anywhere Abhinaya, I do always recount his guidance that I received from him, and do tell people that he is one of the main preceptors, one of the main mentors and gurus to me in matters of Abhinaya. And so thank you for making it possible for me to come back to the school, which I consider as my school, as Dr. Aruna mentioned. And when it was not here, when it was at GT, and must have had visited the school 100 times during the 1990s, and did a lot of work there, and a lot of recordings in the studio there. And Dr. Anuradha, Dr. Aruna, they were all closely working at that time with us, with the Sangeet Natak Akademi series of events, seminars, programs, workshops, and the whole development of thinking that happened, and the processes that were developed by Sangeet Natak Akademi constantly in collaboration with the state department and the university and scholars like you people. And of course, Kala Krishna ji has been for me a guru bhai, because Guruji would consider me also as like Kala Krishna ji, like his son. So and he has always been with me whenever there were issues to do with Andhranatyam or the entire tradition of the Devaganikas of Andhra region. He has constantly been advising me, guiding me. After Guruji left particularly, I had to depend a lot upon Kala Krishna ji for continued support. Even though I am a little out of touch now, having left the Sangeet Natak Akademi, but in some measure I am closer to Guruji now that I am doing more of Abhinaya in my own practice. So with this, I pay my homage to Guruji and begin my presentation, which I have not put down in any systematic, definite, textual form, because I thought I'll proceed as we go. We develop the presentation together in a way as a performing artist always done. My association with Guruji started in 1988. I was then leading the dance department of the Sangeet Natak Akademi, and a very interesting kind of a thing happened. We planned a festival of young dancers here in Hyderabad, I was organizing it, I was conducting it. And I was informed that Guruji, Dr. Nataraj Ramakrishna, who had been awarded the Sangeet Natak Akademi Award in 1983, had not come to Delhi to receive the award. Because of some reasons. Then I was told by our chief, my secretary, and colleagues that who were there earlier, that Guruji was not happy that he was given the award for Bharatanatyam and Kuchipudi, and not for Andhranatyam. So that's how the story began with me about Andhranatyam and my association with Guruji. I said, no, I'm going to Hyderabad, I'll personally take the Academy's award and request Guruji to receive it on behalf of the Sangeet Natak Academy, the award, which is the citation, the Tamrapatra, that is, the shawl and all. And with the help of Mudali Nagabhushan Sharma Garu, that we set up a link with Guruji. At that time, such phones were not, we had to book a trunk call kind of thing, you know, it took a lot of time. I did speak to Guruji somehow, but then and Kalakrishna Ji helped us set up this small, beautiful ceremony at Guruji's residence. He agreed to receive the award. I came and we instantly hit rapport, made great friendship in a way. Once he knew that I was basically a dancer, came from the field of dance, he loved it. And we had this beautiful ceremony at Guruji's residence where I presented to him on behalf of the chairman, behalf of the general council of Sangeet Natak Academy. I handed over the award to him in 1988. 4 years after the award ceremony was held in Delhi. That has been the practice of Sangeet Natak Academy actually. That when an awardee or a fellow is unable to visit Delhi to receive the award from the President of India, the Academy will visit him. Chairman or the secretary, or in a case like this, you know, even I was then not secretary, I was deputy secretary heading the dance department. So that's how the story began, the relationship began, and took, and that also involved me, interested me, and you know, initiated me into the whole subject of Andhranatyam, which was not known outside adequately, except for those scholars of dance and academies where such issues would come up for discussions. Guruji's contribution, at one level, you all are well aware of his contribution. But when I look at it from what Aruna ji said, a national perspective, it was like a very vital segment of India's dance heritage was getting lost, as it were. He, while in Tamil Nadu you find that this process had been undertaken earlier in 1920s, 1930s onwards, and the dance tradition of the Sadar or the Dasi Attam or the Devadasis was duly recontextualized, duly renamed in the new context, and a form of institutional support had begun there. Here, he was the one who initiated this process. The empowerment of a disempowered community. By that time, the Devaganikas of the entire southern region, Maharashtra onwards, you find where the institutional support that was available to them earlier, in the first, you find under temples, when the temples were thriving, later, it comes to the support of the courts, the princes, the principalities, the zamindars. So institutional support provided by what can generically be called darbar, or the courtly institution of royal courts or king's courts. These two institutions had kind of faded away, were fading away, but themselves considerably emaciated and impoverished by that time, at the dawn of the 20th century. Therefore, those who survived on these institutions were even more impoverished and furthermore discriminated against by the laws and the that were enacted at that time against the Devadasi's professions and all that. So this community, which was completely disempowered and their art completely neglected, Guruji's role comes in helping them to reroute themselves in the new context, recontextualize themselves, their art, in the new context of urban India. Institutionalization of their art and their knowledge under a new name. The name becomes very important, and here it's very significant why he thought of calling it Andhranatyam, giving it back to the whole region, giving the region the pride in the art, and giving the votaries of these arts the pride of belonging to this great Telugu nation. The Andhranatyam, this name was not merely, although at the same time, at a lesser level, I look at it as a an effort to, just like Bharatanatyam, people in Tamil Nadu were first to appropriate Bharata, the great Bharata, by calling their tradition as Bharatanatyam. Elsewhere in Odisha, it came by 1940s, the word Odissi started. There, again, the art of Maharis, of Puri temples and Gotipuras, again, of the Puri regions and Odisha as a whole, the art of these traditions were combined together and called Odissi. Again, a national, you know, in China, they call these various traditions as dance of the nationalities, where nation refers to the language, the cultural identity, the linguistic identity, and to some measure ethnic identity also. At another level, nation is an abstract concept. When we talk of nation in our context in India, we are not talking of one language or one religion or one ethnic identity, but as a larger abstract concept of having common ideals, common goals, one sort of a large democracy where we all have a shared destiny. This concept of nation is different from the original concept of nation as it evolved, the term evolved in Europe in the medieval and late medieval period, early modern period in Europe in particular, where it was distinctly linked with the language. And particularly language played a very important role, and culture. Therefore, when I refer to Odia nationalism led them to call it Odissi. In that measure, Telugu nationalism, Andhra nationalism, gave it the name Andhranatyam, if you look at it. But interestingly, within here in Andhra Pradesh, you have very interestingly, you called the Yakshaganas, the Bhagavata's art of Kuchipudi village as Kuchipudi dance. Now that's, I sometimes wonder, what if that place was not, you know the meaning of Kuchipudi, what if that place was not so Kuchi, it was Pedda Pudi, then the dance would have become Pedda Pudi, isn't it? So here, interestingly, the name comes from a very small village, the place where these Bhagavatas lived for generations, worked and evolved their art. So this is how these new names have come. Otherwise, I wonder if it was called Kuchipudi earlier. It was called Yakshagana, Bhagavatam. So, and then you find that the great Rasalila tradition of Manipur gets to be called Manipuri. Gurudev Tagore called it Manipuri, so from 1940s onwards, 30s onwards, it becomes Manipuri art. So this way, but these are very, very significant developments in our dance traditions as a whole. this renaming, giving them a new identity in the new context. Among the Committee of Nations, if I may call it, India as a being made of several national identities merging together to make the Indian nation, they are asserting each one's own cultural personality together to make the larger Indian cultural personality, the larger Indian cultural nation. Therefore, it was important to rename our traditions, the names become then institutions by themselves, and then providing the institutional infrastructure as well, under new dispensation of the academies, the universities, government departments, you find the Andhra Natyam was re-institutionalized here. That was the remarkable contribution of Guruji, bringing them all together, bringing them again, trying to give them roots back in society, in the urban milieu, among the educated middle class, linking up with the governments, with the academy, Sangeet Natak Akademi, which he was the president of, getting it duly recognized, and introducing it in the departments, and writing enormous amount of, just multiple ways he contributed to it. One of these was actually the whole scholarly work, writing so many books, again, which made it possible for the academia and the scholars to access the art, access that tradition, which in many ways was kind of within the close confines of the community, persuading them to come out and share their art with him and with his disciples like Kalakrishna ji and many others. So this, I think, was very... This is... So naturally, when in 1983, he was given the Sangeet Natak Akademi Award for not for Andhra Natyam, or not even in any descriptive name called Art of the Devaganikas of Andhra or the Lasya Traditions of Andhra, but for Bharatanatyam and Kuchipudi, he was hurt. He was disappointed. Therefore, the story began, the whole thing, the association, and this brings me to the whole scenario of Indian dance at that time and earlier, how they all evolved. And it was difficult in some measure when you have an art tradition which is outlived, so to say, its social function. The temple rituals were no more existing, so that functional link was delinked, was removed. That art in the courts, as the Darbar tradition that flourished in the courts, that situation did not exist, so out of the links, it has to be then rerouted in the new context of the manch, the stage, as an art, as a dance art. That was the case with Bharatanatyam, that was the situation with Kathak, with Odissi, and with Andhra Natyam. But different from Manipuri and Satriya, these remain the living traditions even today. They live in their original context. Manipuri Ras tradition, though it's called Manipuri, but primarily this is Rasa Leelas and Natsankirtans, which live, which are performed in the temples there whenever they are required to be performed, and within the communities, so they retain their original social functions. Similarly, Satriya dance tradition as well retains its original links and remains alive in the Satras of Assam, the monastic, the monasteries of created by Mahaprabhu Shankar Deva and his disciple Madhav Deva. So they remain alive in the Satras of Assam, and both Manipuri and Satriya have also made the transition to their stage. It is both, therefore, something, a strength for them as well as certain problems, because when you remain alive in your original social functions, there are several constraints: what to do on stage, what not to do on stage, how much to fiddle with the art while presenting on stage, how much not to. So in that sense, the freedom is less. But then whole corpus exists, remains alive. Therefore, a lot of material remains alive. Here in our case of Andhra Natyam, the whole thing was kind of dying out, had to be resurrected. The great ladies had to be persuaded to come out with, you know, recall and come out and share their art. Therefore, this name today, when we look at from our perspective the importance of Andhra Natyam, I must share with you another important information in this regard is when Sangeet Natak Akademi also founded, we in the academy found it difficult to include Andhra Natyam easily in, and it was not officially listed as a dance art. But we, sometime around 2000, though Kalakrishna ji was recorded, his Navajanadhanam was recorded in detail, and we had in the 90s funded the seminars of Guruji at St. Dominic's. We had then, as part of our series of Kuchipudi and Andhra dance traditions and dance theatre traditions, we had a series of events here in Hyderabad, which were of seminal importance to the Sangeet Natak Akademi, as also to the art forms here. At that time also, Guruji was invited to present all Andhra Natyam, and I think Saridam Manikamma was there, Madhula Lakshmi Narayana was there, and some other, Annabhatula Satyabhama, in fact, she was there, and we had various events organized around it, and focusing on the tradition, yet Andhra Natyam by name had not found a place in the Sangeet Natak Akademi's policies and programs. As a matter of fact, this was because our festival of young dancers, Kalakrishna ji was invited way back 1985-84, and there again we had put his dance as Navajanadhanam, because the Andhra Natyam name, still people were not very sure of being able to use it. So, but things evolved, thinking evolved in the Sangeet Natak Akademi also. And particularly I was very keen, and I asserted that, interestingly, the dance community, by the way, would like that no more. Initially, there were four classical dancers of India in Sangeet Natak Akademi's award list: Kathak, Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, and Manipuri. And the doors were kind of closed. In 1964, Satriya was also included for 1 year. Then the doors were closed. Unfortunately, it's not the scholars or the administrators, it's the artists themselves. The community of artists would like to say, no more, these are the classical dancers. We belong to that hallowed world of classical dances, not you. But in came Odissi in the 60s, Kuchipudi, later in the 70s, Mohini Attam, and you know, Yeah. So what happens is that understanding grows, realization grows, as more and more interaction happened and participation happened. So I believe, from national point of view, India is a great culture, so many people, there are so many major traditions of dance and music and dance theater still to be resurrected, which have been lost. Therefore, we decided in our festival in the year 2006 or 2007 of senior dancers, we had Andhra Natyam, We had Vilasini also by that time, the name had come to be. So we had Anupama also performing in that festival in Kolkata. We had Gaudiya Nitya of Bengal, which was a complete reconstruction being done by a remarkable scholar and dancer. And we, of course, had Satriya. Satriya by that time had been included in the list. So, and this was, the leadership was provided by the then chairman, Sri Ramnivas Mirdhaji, who said that more the merrier. India is too large, has been such a great tradition, such a long culture it has had, and many of these great traditions have been lost. So Sangeet Natak Academy needs to have its doors open for all of them. And that's how we persuaded our board and our dance committee to look at these all these forms as not in terms of individuals who are representing these forms, but as significant traditions of our dance heritage, of our dance and dance theater heritage. Secondly, a very major problem occurs when you refer to and you fall into the trap of this terminology is called classical, non-classical, classical, traditional, folk, tribal. This English language, one of the problems is that we remain imprisoned in the and have retained that colonial imperialist mind, that the control that they had on our mind in terms of their culture, their language. So English language, when we use it, we'll fall into many traps. So what is the definition of classical, people will ask. Sangeet Natak Academy, therefore, had the right approach in its awards scheme does not use the word classical. Aruna ji asked me to give a national perspective. I'm trying to link up everything. Let me tell you, Sangeet Natak Academy as the National Academy of India does not officially use the word classical in its official classification in the award, Academy Awards. That is the only officially approved categories you find in the Sangeet Natak Academy Awards list, where the major heading is dance, not classical dance. Under dance comes Bharatanatyam 1, Kathak 2, Kathakali 3, Manipuri 4, Kuchipuri 5, Odissi 6, Mohiniyattam 7, Chau 8, and Satriya 9, like that. So what are these? These are all, then we gave further thought to it, and I said for the purpose of our understanding, general understanding, we let alone, let people know that these are major traditions of dance. We won't get into calling them classical dance and thereby meaning that some other dances are not classical, as if they are the second category of citizens or something. So these are major traditions of dance, and by name they are placed in the Sangeet Natak Academy's award list. Then in the major review, the important review that was undertaken of these awards scheme during my tenure, that these nomenclatures were created as major traditions, we included the within the dance list a group called other major traditions of dance. And these other major traditions of dance were required to be listed by name, not open just like that. So Andhra Natyam, Sri Kalakrishna Garu was given the award for Andhra Natyam as in the dance main dance list as other major traditions of dance. That's how it got to be duly approved by the Sangeet Natak Academy, duly accepted by the Sangeet Natak Academy at the national level. So these are the methods, the various methods that have to be developed to, as we are understanding grows with regard to our traditions. And that is why today when I find that within the region, within Hyderabad, within say now you have the issue of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh as two states. So within the region, when these names there seem to be confusion about, and the whole remarkable work done by Guruji seems to have been sort of interfered with at a particular point of time, and the focus on Andhra Natyam getting lost because of various other views and other names coming up. And very interestingly, you find that in Sangeet Natak Akademi's award list, I find 2 years ago, that one representative of the same tradition, which comes under Andhra Natyam, got the award for Lakshmi Mangathayaru getting Leela Sai, getting the award for Kalavanthulu, traditional theatre. So this I thought was a step backwards, not for individual reasons. The fact is that A, it was called traditional theatre, B, the name Kalavanthulu came back, harking back to older days. Now these are the issues which have to be looked at from our perspective, from the perspective of from national perspective. I would say this is an interesting development, but I'm not sure if this is the right development. This development is the right side, because then things will scatter. All the work that has been done under Andhra Natyam by Guruji will get scattered, and therefore it is the right time for people here, for the state, as well as the thinkers and scholars in the universities, all of them, to put our resources and thinking and all our might together to evolve a clear strategy and a policy, and clinch the issue now with a definite terminology. Not jettisoning the old terminology, but retaining it, but arriving at a consensus. That is very important, and that will be a lasting tribute to Guru Nataraj Ramakrishna ji for all his lifetime's work that he has done. With this background of I'll move on to some larger picture. Though personally I would love to share how much I learned from him, not directly, but while I was recording him in your studio in GT, and twice in Sangeet Natak Akademi's studio in Delhi, and his whole concept of Sattvika Abhinaya, and never had that kind of a fortune of coming down and learning that kind of a leisure and time. But I constantly watched him, interacted with him, and the whole my whole approach to Abhinaya, Sattvika Abhinaya, really I imbibed from him, from his recordings, his talks, his lectures, and interactions with him. And that is something with my own performances and presentations and teachings that take place. I have taught Abhinaya in Manipur, in Assam, in Orissa, in Kolkata, apart from Delhi, and in US and all. I always tell them about the importance of Guruji's work and what I learned from him, and the Sattvika Abhinaya, how it is to be, whatever little I learned from him. So this is a very personal kind of indebtedness I owe to Guruji. Even perhaps Kalakrishna ji would not be as aware as I'm telling today that I do emote a lot while teaching Abhinaya, while performing Abhinaya. I, for example, let me, with your permission, Aruna ji, I sort of wear away from the main topic, that is, I did this famous thumari, Rasake Bhare Tore Nain. I used to do a lot of it, where for half an hour, I would just sit and had a lovely, excellent singer to sing for 20 minutes or half an hour. I will just, because it has to do with Rasake Bhare Tore Nain. So Nain and eyes and the rasa. I would only be trying to emote through my eyes and the, all the and the face, and gradually from the upper part of the body, sitting at one place. So sattvika abhinaya, you know, and like Guruji in this wonderful little film says that the abhinaya has to do with mudras. Hastakas are not required. You have to do the abhinaya with your eyes. Your eyes must speak. This came so clearly, so starkly clear from Guruji's own teaching, his own demonstration, his performance as we recorded. So this is, I hope that this art of Abhinaya that Guruji mastered and tried to pass on to his disciples goes farther and more people benefit from it. When we talk of performing arts, in the Sangeet Natak Academy, the national body, the national government, and let me first of all also mention at this right at the outset, is that national view is not the view developed in Delhi, should not be thought of in terms of New Delhi One. New Delhi One, you know, what is New Delhi One? New Delhi One is the seat of power, seat of governance of Indian democracy, Indian Republic. Sangeet Natak Academy is also located within New Delhi One. So is the Ministry of Culture, of course, the Parliament and the the main bodies of the whole Indian government. National view, I used to always say that a nation is made by the regions. Now I say nation lives in the regions. Not in New Delhi One, definitely not. They, in fact, we sitting in New Delhi, pretending to be great national leaders or national administrators or what have you, learn, in fact, by going into the actual interiors of the nation. It is your view, therefore, it is the view of the Andhra nation which will determine the view of Delhi, which will actually guide the view of Delhi. Sangeet Natak Academy knew it earlier. That is where you have a lovely body of this General Council of Representatives from all the whole country. You have 20 artists co-opted from all over the region. So they are constantly contributing, talking, and developing a view together with regard to performing arts. But when we take a talk of, it is this, to gain that understanding on the part for the center and for the Sangeet Natak Academy that we planned the series of events focused on Kuchipudi and Andhra traditions in the 1990s. But what was the reason behind it? And this was a larger policy view, but the specific reason was the failure, if I may say so, of or inability of the State Department of Culture to give us suitable support, suitable recommendations, suitable collaboration in terms of understanding, in terms of artist status of the artist, the standard of teaching of Kuchipudi and so on and so forth. In fact, Academy always used to work, it was the policy of the Sangeet Natak Academy to work in collaboration with the state academies. We would never bypass the state academies. And where these academies were not functional, we would not bypass the state departments of culture when we have to do with traditions of that particular state. We depended upon individual resource persons and experts from each state who would be sitting on our council that would be advising us and sort of also coordinating with the state departments and state academies. That's how we will, that was the style of functioning, that was the process of working of the Sangeet Natak Academy. So Sangeet Natak Academy therefore had the right view right from the beginning. That is, we sitting in Delhi and we were never guided by the ministry, didn't allow the interference of the bureaucrats in the ministry at all. Our executive board would determine, which had people from all over the country. So, yet at that time we found that Andhra, the people from Andhra, the government, the department, and the, unfortunately your academy had been abolished during NTR's regime. The Andhra Pradesh Sangeet Nritya Academy, all academies were abolished. Telugu Vijnana Peetam was created first, and then Telugu University. And these had not taken over the responsibility of the academy. Academy's role is distinctly different from the role of a university. So we were finding it very difficult to receive feedback from the region, even specific grants application forms from the institutions and artists from the region. Though no informed comments were coming forth from the Department of Culture. And then there were institutions and artists who would complain of the one or two resource persons who were working with us that he is biased or she is biased or he has his own favorites and things like these. So it's always been our style of working, which is necessary for evolving a national view, that we have multiple resource persons from within the same region, from within the same tradition. We do not talk to just one, but we talk to several of them and get different views and then collate and coalesce and combine and develop a consensus. So that became a problem. Then we decided to directly move into the Andhra Pradesh and have a series of events focusing on the Kuchipudi and Andhra traditions to take stock of the standard of teaching here. We had this 9-day festival with 75 Kuchipudi dance teachers who were called to present their young students, young disciples, and so on and so forth. So here again, for evolving what you call a national view, the nation, so-called central, the Delhi is wholly dependent on where the activity is, the regions, where the nation lives, actually lives. Your Indian nation does not live in New Delhi, which was created by the British in 1920s as a new capital of India. And in fact, Delhi's own culture is completely neglected. The old Delhi is very sidelined. New Delhi is, you can imagine, and bureaucratic approach, political seat of power and all that. So that kind of a place cannot give the national view. A national view is developed only within where the nation lives. Therefore, having said that, I would like to read out something that will further the Sangeet Natak Academy was set up by the Government of India in 1952 as the apex national body for the preservation and promotion of the country's performing arts. Its inauguration in January 1953 by the first President of India in the Central Hall of the Parliament, just days after the inauguration of the newly elected Parliament itself of the Republic of India, signified the role and responsibility it was meant to shoulder as a cultural pillar of the emergent republic. 1952 was a very important year for India. The young people are not aware, they were not born, but 1950 we had India as a republic and the constitution was adopted. 1952 you find, say, the new first parliament getting created, so many national institutions getting created, inaugurated, the 5-year plans being launched. So So 1952 becomes very significant year from the national point of view, national governance, national policy making point of view. And that's how Sangeet Natak Akademi was conceived, inaugurated in 1953. And together with his two sister, it was hoped that, it was expected that the Academy on behalf of the state would take over the role and responsibility of the erstwhile courts and princes in providing the much needed support and patronage to the country's performing art traditions and practices, threatened due to years of colonial rule. Together with its two sister academies, that is the Sahitya Academy and Lalit Kala Academy, an ecosystem and the academies which were set up in the states, because all the states had the same party government at that time, so many states followed quickly with their Sangeet Natak Academies and their Lalit Kala Academies. An ecosystem was sought to be created that would hopefully help sustain, develop and enrich the artistic and literary traditions and practices of India. But it is necessary to understand what do we mean by performing arts. What happens is all the dancers remain in their own world of classical dance, high art. All the theatre people remain in the world of drama and theatre. Musicians remain in their own world and they do not look down upon, but they feel themselves quite strange. But then, what were the traditions and practices that the Sangeet Natak Akademi was meant to look after? So here is a small para that I have written which will give you an idea of what is the performing arts heritage we were talking about. India's multiracial, multilingual, multireligious society spread across the varied geographical and cultural regions of the subcontinent, having a memory of some thousands of years of history and of yugas and kalpas beyond history, has given expression to an astounding range of performing arts. At one end were the classical, in quotes, so-called classical music and dance traditions, the venerable Vedic chants and Sanskrit theatre like Kudiyattam, and the great knowledge tradition texts like Natya Shastra, and so on. On the other end were the emerging popular, what we call in quotes, popular expressions of music, dance and drama in the new mass media of radio and films, which later became popular as Bollywood dancing, Bollywood music and all. Equally notable were the social dramas, mobile theatres, street plays and Puranic Natakas prevalent in the towns and villages, as well as the urban theatre art, the art drama, which is the urban theatre, distinct from the traditions, something which is as art theatre, in major Indian languages emerging in the cities. Between the two ends of the classical and the popular, there lay a large wealth of the performance expressions of the peoples of India that we variously and perhaps inadequately classify as traditional, folk, or tribal. Borrowed English words, traditional, folk, tribal. These were the innumerable forms of music, dance, theatre, puppetry, ballads, hymns, chants, martial arts, mystical, magical, trance performances, and the related crafts of making masks, screens, stage props, musical instruments, ankle belts, costumes, headgears, ornaments, makeup, etc. All these traditions have been alive in the lives of all the communities of India, whether as part of their life cycle rituals or of livelihoods or household chores or religious practices or caste community celebrations. These forms of arts give expression to and sustain the values, the aesthetics, and the very memory and worldview of each community. So you find this vast, huge mass of practices, performance practices is what we would call the performing arts of India. And this vast and mostly intangible corpus of India's cultural heritage that the Sangeet Natak Akademi was required to take cognizance of, comprehend, analyze, interpret, conceptualize, define, categorize, classify, and codify in order to develop appropriate policies, strategies, and programs aimed at their preservation and promotion. So you find, if you suddenly realize you are all in this wonderful world of academics, you understand what each word means. When I say the academy was required to take cognizance of such a huge mass, comprehend, try to understand what it is. I'll give you any number of examples. Kudi Atam is a great tradition, but in Sangeet Natak Akademi's executive board minutes of one of the early 5 years, you find reference to Chakyar Kut, not Kudi Atam, as important traditions. They listed out several important traditions which needed to be looked into, including the Bhagavatam of Kuchipudi people at that time. This is early 1950s. So, take cognizance of, comprehend, try to understand what the hell it is. Analyze. Then interpret. Interpret to each other. People from Andhra interpreting it to people from Odisha, from people from Punjab. And you know, and then in the academic circles as well as in the practicing circles. Then arrive at a concept, conceptualize. Once gaining a concept, conceptualization, move on to the next stage of giving a definition, a larger definition, define. And this will help in categorizing them, categorize. As if categorization is that easy. For that matter, what is dance? What is dance theater? What is Natya? When you use the English word, you fall into one trap. From there, you try to get out and get into our own traditional, our concepts of Natya, Ritya, Nitya. And you find that Natya also means dance, but Natya also is theater, drama. But isn't our dance tradition also the theater or not? So the problem of using an English language, trying to understand things by use of another language, is so sometimes disheartening, self-defeating, and so frustrating. You'll find it a lot easier to talk in Telugu to each other and analyze everything in Telugu, in your own language. You will be closer to the truth. You will be closer to what the fact is. But the moment you start using another language, you fall into these traps. But the Sangeet Natak Akademi and the national governance policy at that time, English language was the English language of communication. So we had to do this work. But so categorize, define, categorize, then classify. And then after having done that, codify. There's another very dangerous thing to do is to codify anything in a living tradition, in a constantly flowing tradition. Maulana Azad, the first minister at the inauguration of the Sangeet Natak Akademi, where Jawaharlal Nehru was present, and of course the President of India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, inaugurated it, as I said, in the Central Hall of the Parliament. He said, the traditions cannot be preserved, but can only be created afresh. That became a dictum, Sangeet Natak Akademi. Traditions can be preserved only by creating afresh. But in the same breath, he says the Sangeet Natak Akademi is created to give institutional form to these arts, these traditions. And it will preserve and promote. So you have this constantly going back and forth, talking of preservation, talking of creation. Preservation cannot be done without constant creation. And tradition cannot remain meaningful and functional unless it is constantly recreated. So, a tradition cannot be preserved, it can only be created afresh. So this became a leitmotif of Sangeet Natak Akademi's policies and programs. The other very important principle that has to be borne in mind is performing art is created only when performed. Because of the particular nature of performing art, it is performed, it's ephemeral, and it is not something written down. Like a poet can be in a far away, sit in his idyllic upavan or whatever and write a poem. It gets written, it gets documented in words, in letters, and the poet is presence is not required for you to enjoy his poetry. He doesn't have to be present. Similarly, the work of sculpture or fine art, painting and all these are done in isolation, not in the presence, not to be performed in the presence of the spectators, the audience. But performing art has a different nature. So it became again an important dictum of the Academy and the Government of India that it has to, performance has to be supported. If we have to revive, strengthen the tradition, first of all, we have to give direct support to the performance, to multiply performance opportunities, resurrect, revive, and rejuvenate the performance, the movement of performances. Create more and more performance situations, make the traditions. Am I taking too long? I don't know. Well, that's the problem with the national view. I have not started theater, I have not come to music and all that. And so you're talking of the national, how Sangeet Natak Akademi looked at it. Performances, therefore, there's no other way, no amount of recording and documentation alone will help, or teaching alone will help, unless you create the manch, the space for performance and make more and more performances to happen, make more and more artists perform. And they themselves will take care. That will help preserve the art. Of course, teaching is important, development of teaching, theoretical knowledge, the constant dialogue between theory and the practice, the Shastra and the Prayoga has to be taken care of for the performances to evolve to a great level. So this again was very, very important, the performances. I think shall I close here at this point so that you could ask further and I could elaborate further, I could answer and develop the proceedings further. The major tradition, music also, I'll similarly, we know of Hindustani Sangeet. Again, in the music list, we don't say classical Hindustani music, classical Carnatic music. Academy says Hindustani music, Carnatic music. To that, we added other major traditions. By defining these as major traditions of music, we added other major traditions of music in our awards list. What were these other major traditions? These are very, very, these are the most important traditions, whether it is Sopana Sangeetam of Kerala, whether it is Odissi Sangeet of Odisha, or Mand of Rajasthan, or Borgit of Assam, or Natasankirtan of Manipur, or like that, you know, Harikatha, the whole larger tradition of Harikatha that exists across this region, of southern region. These are the important major traditions of music, which are, to my mind, great storehouses. We realize that these are truly the great storehouse of our musical knowledge and huge corpus of lyrics and the compositions, the sahitya that are stored in these compositions, which needed to be taken due note of, due notice of, due cognizance of in a larger national view of India's traditions. Similarly in theatre, now theatre, very quickly, I'll tell you in a few words, in theatre what happened was urban theatre practices, contemporary urban theatre practices weighed heavy on Sangeet Natak Akademi, and because urban, naturally English is speaking and all that, and in major Indian languages, major cities, but the traditions of theatre that existed in India, continue to exist, were kind of sidelined, not given due importance to. What are these? Sri Krishnattam of Kerala, tamasha of Maharashtra, khayal of Rajasthan, bhavai of Gujarat, and so on and so forth. So these important traditions of theatre again were to be brought in as major traditions of theatre in our awards list. So this is how you must, however, imagine that and realize that it's only in 47 that we got independence. 1950s onwards, we started putting our things together, trying to understand. It's just about what, 75 years, less than that. It is too short a period for a great republic, for a great country, for a government in this complex democracy to evolve its concepts, evolve its ideas of its, understand itself, its culture, its people. And that process must continue, is continuing. It'll take a longer view for us to arrive at a certain point from where we can have a perspective view of the whole scenario. With this, I conclude my presentation, and I invite questions, interactions that you would like to have. Any questions if you have?
So I invite Professor Anuradha to give the vote of thanks.
Are you sure that you don't have any questions? Because this would be the last. Any. No, I was wondering whether with such multiplicity, you're talking about the multiplicity of our culture and things like that, do we need to have a kind of one perspective to look at them? Because you started in a very different way, that there is it takes time to arrive at a perspective. Why should we?
It'll take time for us to come to that point where Guruji came at the end saying that don't know anything. You know, that understanding of the essential truth, that's all. What as a whole we are made of, that's all. Not one perspective, must be multiple perspectives all the time. In fact, for that matter, even in our daily activity, there are different points of view. The government's point of view, the academy's point of view, the points of view that evolve in the academia, in the university setup, the points of view of the practitioners of the art, the dancers, the artist's point of view, how an artist will look at his or her art, how the audience, the rasikas look at the art, and how the intellectuals look at the art. So even at any given point of view, there are different points of view. And these different points of view must always be cherished, and would then combine to have a richer understanding and richer view.
I think I'm treading into a kind of a difficult area. Of late, probably a few months back, I was invited to be a part of a committee which was constituted to recommend recognition of a particular dance form as classical. Is it the one at the top, the government, that decides whether that is classical or not, or whether will it come from down, from the artists and the practitioners and the scholars?
I'm very happy that you have raised this very, very vital issue. And yes, that's what, when I said in another way I put it, that the nation lives here, not in New Delhi, not at the top.
No, but it looks like, you know, everything comes from above. I mean, we are, as a university, I'm talking as an academic institution, we have been having autonomy in thinking and in our pursuits, what we want to pursue, what kind of projects do we need to do. But it looks like it's now taking a U-turn, where things are now being coming. And I see this as a part and parcel, this constitution of a committee to recognize a particular art form as classical.
It was a blatantly wrong thing to do. I tell you, since you raised it, I didn't put it. I said, philosophically, I put it that nation lives here. When we had the issue of the Satriya dance, I mentioned the Satriya dance was in the main list of dance in the Academy Awards in 1964, along with Kathakali and Bharatanatyam. Then it lost the race, as it were, somewhere got sidelined. When this issue came up, you know, Satriya has been so-called formally recognized by the Sangeet Natak Academy, as they would say, in the year 2000.
But what point do you recognize?
There were parliament questions about it. They wanted us to recognize and things like these, the members of parliament from Assam. And we wrote to the parliament. I was the author behind all these things, you know. That we, the Sangeet Natak Academy, the government of India, have no authority to recognize or not recognize any tradition as classical or so on. There's nothing, we said this classical word itself is misleading in the Indian context. We have our own parameters, we have our own great traditions, we have the concepts of Natya Dharmi and, you know, Loka Dharmi and all these things. But in any case, it's not the Sangeet Natak Academy, the government of India's role to say you are classical, you are not classical. It is entirely lies within the realm and purview of the practitioners, the gurus, the scholars and the thinkers of that community, that society, that region, who are the stakeholders of that art. Therefore, we refused that, and this committee, or recently also, this again came up for another dance form. I was also in subsequent committee, I was there, and I took a stand there that no, Sangeet Natak Academy and Government of India should not do it. Don't arrogate yourself. Don't have the arrogance of granting recognition. New Delhi can never afford to have such an arrogance. Nobody sitting at the top can say you are classical, you are not classical, or you are great, you are not great. But this, towards its artistic traditions, the people, the scholars, the thinkers, the leaders of the art, they have a responsibility towards their own art. They have to say, that's what Satriya, therefore, is they who declared it. All we did was guide them. I personally guided the Assam government, Assam academia, gurus, all of them, the right path, how to empower themselves, how to declare themselves. Sangeet Natak Academy did not give any recognition as classical or whatsoever. Sangeet Natak Academy, making an understanding of the wealth of the tradition, included Satriya in the list of dance. I mentioned to you that there's a list of award. It does not use the word classical.
Major traditions.
Major traditions. It doesn't even say the major traditions directly. It just say dance. The explanation is major traditions. This is something that I am the culprit of bringing this terminology. But it just say dance, Bharatanatyam, Kathak, Kathakali, Manipuri and so on, and Satriya comes there. And we have given enough hint, and I particularly personally have tried to give that leadership to see how in the same list Andhra Natyam comes and the other major traditions. The idea was the first they will be linked up here, then from there such forms will be placed in the list. That has not happened after I left. So you are right, definitely not from the top, no such thing. If it is happening now, it is sad and unfortunate.
Any other queries.
I would definitely recommend towards that, and I would direct every fourth. I mean, it's an opportunity for me to again interact in the context. Is that I had talked about the need to have that kind of a seminar and a larger event focusing on this vital and huge, the very, very rich tradition that have been given to us, betrothed to us by the Devaganikas of the Andhra region. And both the states must come together to create such a large event of seminar, presentations, its academic aspect, its practical aspects, its music, its talas and everything, and its symbol, rituals and everything, to knock the head of those who are sitting up there and thinking that they are the ones who can decide.
Thank you so much. It's been a kind of a thought provoking, because we all feel that Sangeet Natak Academy is the one which decides, but now we are out of that myth that it's we who would decide and you would do it. But I don't know how far this is still continue to be the spirit of Sangeet Natak Academy. But
I tell you, since we're discussing, this part need not be put out there in the what I'm talking.
It will be there.
It will be recorded, all right. Yeah, yes. Don't put everything up on the web or the YouTube or anything, you know. You see, I just help them understand, the great people of Assam, that why look towards Delhi? Look within. Look within, and they, once it was made clear to the bureaucrats, the secretary culture, the key senior officers and the chief minister and the scholars and all of them, they went about it in a beautiful way, doing the whole thing in no time.
Yeah.
They planned such an event, having national scholars to attend. We were there just to guide them and help them. And lo and behold, within no time, it was all achieved. And they declared it officially in a huge function, where the governor, the chief minister, all the who's who of Assam were present, in which they said themselves declared it. So you should do it here too.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Jayantji, having taken off from your time and schedule, because it's been, I think, from October, the entire request for this particular lecture has started from our side.
Yeah.
So final thank you to you, and then also thanks to the Vice-Chancellor, the Dean of the school, and the head of the department for having taken the pains to conduct and organize this particular Nataraja
Ramakrishna. I was half a mind, actually, you know, before coming, I was thinking of postponing it because of my ailment.
Yeah.
But I thought it has been fixed, and it is, you know, all the university
it has to happen.
Has to happen within March.
I also thank my colleagues, particularly Professor Shivraju, for he is the one who works behind the scene, never on to the stage, but behind the scene, organizing everything, putting things meticulously. So thanks to him for having done this. And of course, the social science authorities for having given us this particular auditorium, the other supporting staff, and the PRO's office for having supported us in organizing this. And last but not the least, the entire supporters, disciples of Nataraj Ramakrishna Garu, close associates of Nataraj Ramakrishna Garu who could come today, and also the students and research scholars of the department majorly who are here for this particular lecture. Thanks to you all.